Hey, MMA fans out there, it's Dwight Wakabayashi here, feature columnist, Bleacher Report MMA. Hope everyone is doing really well and getting ready for Christmas. It's UFC 140 week here in Toronto. Lots of things going on this week. It's an early Christmas present for me. It's going to be a great week, but this is the submission. This is episode number 5. And in this one, it's all about the MMA Expo. This past weekend on Saturday, the MMA Expo was in Mississauga at the Pearson International Center. I was able to go check it out. They have lots of exhibits on hand, many apparel booths, and there's also a grappling tournament, a jiu-jitsu tournament with the youth leagues going on, and of course many UFC stars in attendance. I was able to take a lot of video, walk the floor, and get some interviews, and that's all going to be on this episode in a video coming up. Right after I get done gabbing. Basically, I was able to talk to Mac Danzig. I was able to talk to Canadian star and former UFC veteran Carlos Newton. I was able to also talk to Ryan the Real Deal Ford, a great welterweight in Canada, a really cool guy. And also, I was able to really get the highlight of my weekend and talk to UFC Octagon girl, Brittney Palmer, who's making her return this weekend at UFC 140. So check it out.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Saw your fight with Matt Wyman. Excellent fight.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Great for you to be in Toronto.
Yeah.
You fought in Calgary, Montreal, everywhere.
Yeah. Edmonton.
When are you going to come here and get it on?
Hopefully soon. Looks like I might be doing Montreal in March. Nothing is signed. Everything is just still up in the air right now. But that's what we might be looking at is Montreal again in March. So I always love coming to Canada. It's a great time. Yeah.
Any possible names there?
Nobody's been mentioned for sure. You know, like there's people out there that might fit, like Dennis Seaver or something. But it'd be bad for me to mention any names, because unless it's signed, they don't like you say anything.
Same thing, right?
But on top of that, really no one's been even talked about in a serious way yet. Okay. So yeah,
I'd love to see Seaver.
Yeah, he's a great fighter, man. Everybody's good. There's nobody out there that wouldn't be a great fight, in my opinion. Everyone on roster right now is really good. So
a couple more things. Lightweight division, you just said it, it's nobody's bad. You're seeing all these guys at the top right now. Yeah. Where do you see yourself fitting in? Maybe like a 10 to 20 ranking
Don't know. I try not to think about that stuff. I just take it one fight at a time. You know, obviously a loss, even if it was a close fight, is a setback. So
yeah, that was a tough one.
Yeah, that loss to Wyman was like, it doesn't help you in the rankings. But UFC not having really official rankings, and also the fact that they say that they don't plan on having any anytime soon, it's just kind of like, I feel like you're only as good as your last fight. So right now I just have to get back on the horse. And, if you get like 5 or 6 wins in a row, then obviously you might be looking at a title shot, especially depending on who you end up fighting in that winning streak. So my goal is just to get a winning streak going. And I don't know. I mean, I think that anyone in the top 30 at 155 is all capable of beating each other on any given night. That's how stacked the division is. So
definitely
just try to keep focused and get back in there.
Perfect. Are you staying for the week and catching the card?
No.
I'm
out of here on Sunday, so just here for the expo. Yeah,
well, it's a pleasure to talk to you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot, man.
The big show.
All right, I'm here with monster Canadian fighter Ryan Ford. Ryan, good to see you.
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Last time I saw you, you put a nice whipping on Carl Parisian in London. You've had a couple fights since then. What gives, man? When are you going to be in the big show?
Man, you know, I ask myself the same question all the time, you know. I believe, you know, God's got his path for me, and, you know, he's going to take me to where, you know, he wants me to be. As far as then, I'm just going to keep fighting whoever they put in front of me and make sure I put them down, and, you know, just wait for that call.
So what or who is next for you?
Right now we're trying to lock down an opponent right now. We got a few names right now, so I'm not real sure, but my next fight's going to be with Aggression MMA February 11th.
Okay.
In Edmonton, and whoever it is, you know, I'm bringing my A game. I've switched camps now. I'm over at TriStar now training.
Oh, okay.
You know, so it's actually, I think, the first time that I've been training with high-level guys in my whole 4.5 career, so I know my game's going to step up with just being around all those guys.
That's good. And are you actually going to be catching next weekend's card?
Yeah, actually, I'm going home. I've been out Montreal for a month right now, so I'm going home on Sunday after the Expo. I haven't seen family for a month, so, you know, I'm kind of excited. I got to get home and
get
see
home
them.
And see him, yep.
You know, spend the Christmas, and then I'll watch it on pay-per-view.
Who can I get a call for? Jones Machida?
Bones Jones.
Easily?
Easily. Whatever Easily. Way he wants to do it, he's going to do it.
Perfect. Well, thanks a lot, Ryan.
All right, no problem. Thanks.
Alright, I'm here at the MMA Expo with Carlos the Ronin Newton, one of Canada's all-time best. Just wanted to ask a few questions, Carlos. Recently, I did with UFC 140 coming, I did up an all-time great list and had you at number 7. I'm wondering from you, the man himself, where do you see yourself in the history of Canadian MMA? I see you right at the top. Is that something you think about, or?
I see myself as the first.
Number
there.
One.
Yeah.
The pioneer.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know that recently you just had a big scrap with Brian Ebersole, and you're seeing him kind of climb the rankings. When are we going to see Carlos Newton back in the UFC?
Retired.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm
didn't know you were retired for sure for good.
No, I'm having a good time. I'm retired.
Nice.
Yeah. Focusing on things now, you know, just building my family.
Your family and also your gym?
Yeah, building my gym, just, you know, just building my life after fighting and just kind of enjoying myself and continue learning and growing as a person. That's what I enjoy doing. It's always been my goal.
And you've had some of the best fights that we've ever seen, really, in the mixed martial arts. And my question for you is, what's your favorite? What's your favorite fight that you've ever had?
My favorite fight is still my fight with Dan Henderson. It's probably favorite.
Try to develop some sort of a Hall of Fame. You know, guys like yourself, Gary Goodridge. Is that something that Canada has?
You
would know,
great.
Probably.
You know, have our MMA history all out there for everyone to learn about. And, because it's also something that will help set an example for other fighters, you know, younger athletes. You know, a lot of times I say, if you want to get somewhere in life and you know somebody's already there, you know, you follow
talk
them.
To them, exactly. You know? Thanks a lot. Thanks for taking the time, Carlos. I'm here with Brittney Palmer, the lovely and talented Your fans, I know you're pursuing your dream right now out in LA, but were you surprised actually at the backlash, I guess, and the you were surprised?
Yeah, I mean, you know, at the end of the day, I'm an Octagon girl, you know. I don't think that I never thought that my job was so important until, you know, I left. I mean, I know it's important, but I didn't think anyone really took notice of it until I left. And it's super cool. My fans are awesome, but I didn't even think I had as many as I did. So.
Exactly. I think they just fell in love with you right away, and so we're happy to have you back here in Canada for 140 next weekend.
Yeah. Yeah.
And my last question for you is Las Vegas, L.A.?
L.A.
Yeah.
L.A.
And you're from Las Vegas.
I'm from Las Vegas. I know, but it's so hot.
Okay.
And nothing to do. And I live in Venice Beach, so it's all artsy and the beach and the surfing.
It's perfect. Jones or Machida?
Jones.
Dominant?
Jones?
Yeah. Dominant? Thank you very much for your time.
So there you have it, folks. The MMA Expo. It's a great event. Brittney Palmer was the highlight. You saw right there at the end. She's probably one of my faves. As much as I like the fighters, and check it out. It tours around, and keep your eye on it. It's on the web, it's on Facebook, and definitely if you like MMA, check it out when it comes to a town near you. Also this weekend, it's 140. Going to be posting all kinds of video this week. Starting tomorrow, there's going to be events every day leading up to the fight. Fight week is awesome. All kinds of fighters coming into town probably today, tomorrow. And it's going to be a great card. UFC 140, Jones Machida, ACC, all kinds of Canadian fighters, folks. And make sure you check it out if you love mixed martial arts. I appreciate you following. For all your MMA news, please follow me, Dwight Wakabayashi, Bleacher Report MMA. Also, MMACanada.net. Shout out to Charles Rock. And also, CKSN.ca. Shout out to Ian Kennedy. Thank you very much, folks, and enjoy your MMA.